Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
We had a very interesting session, and I must say that this topic is very interesting. What I really liked is, guru of his stature using a PPT to tell us. That's technology, where it has reached. So it was really interesting to watch. And I'm very proud to be here, and I have a panel with me of very distinguished members from the field of education. And how we're going to do is that we'll give two minutes to each person to please introduce yourself and tell us about yourself, and or maybe a minute, 1 minute. And I was being generous. And then we can discuss the topic, and I can give you a question, and we would love to have the audience interacting. So before I pass on the mic to Abhinav to my right, I wanted to ask you, the topic is, how do we integrate technology and innovative pedagogy in the classroom to reach up to the global standards? All of you have a smartphone? Yes? So can yaar acche tarah interest se bolo. Smartphones everybody is using. You must be sending to your boyfriend or husband, I can make out, right? So no, you don't have one, we'll find one. So the smartphones, if you must have used Google Map. How many of you used a Google Map to come here?
Excuse me ma'am, one more panelist now, he's with us, Mr. Kumar Gaurav. He's an associate director, upgrade.
Okay. Yep. Okay, so we welcome him.
Mr. Kumar Gaurav, please join us.
Mr. Gaurav, a warm welcome. And so what I was saying is, if you go on the Google Map, and if you go to the three lines on the top, you want to check it out, you can do it right now. Click on that, you can see your timelines. You will see each and every place you have visited. That is technology. We are surrounded by technology. How do we introduce it in the classroom in an innovative manner? Why are we running away from it? We say, Alyssa, start the TV. Do we do it? Alyssa, Netflix. How many of us do it? Quite a few of us. And we are still running away from it. So just a little bit before I pass on, I read these lines and I want to share. Before what happened, before the computers, an applicant was for employment. A program was a TV show. A cursor used profanity, a keyboard was a piano, cut you did with scissors, paste you did with glue, a web was a spider's home, and a virus was the flu. So thank you so much, and I would request you to please introduce yourself quickly in a line and two, and then we'll pass on, and then we'll start with the question answer.
सबसे पहले, इससे पहले कि मैं अपना नाम बताऊं और मैं क्या करता हूं वो बताऊं, मैं चाहूंगा कि आप सब लोगों के चेहरे पे एक छोटी सी खुशी हो, क्योंकि आप सब लोग एजुकेशन से जुड़े हुए हैं. मैं भी एजुकेशनिस्ट हूं, और एजुकेशनिस्ट के लिए एक लाइन लिखी थी कबीराना साहब ने कि काम सब गैर ज़रूरी है जो सब करते हैं, आप कुछ नहीं करते गज़ब करते हैं, आप कुछ नहीं करते गज़ब करते हैं. तो ये पैनल डिस्कशन तभी मज़ेदार होगा जब आप चेयरफुल होंगे, वरना हम लोग अपने पॉइंट्स रख के चले जाएंगे. और इंटेलेक्चुअल्स के बीच में बैठकर अपने पॉइंट्स को रखना और चेहरे पे मुस्कान लाना, मुझे लगता है ये बहुत बड़ी सक्सेस की बात है. तो मेरा नाम डॉक्टर अनु त्रिपाठी है, मैं फौज के मेडिकल कॉलेज से पढ़ा हूँ, आर्म फोर्स मेडिकल कॉलेज पुणे. वहाँ से पढ़ने के बाद मैंने चूज़ किया कि मैं इंडिया में डॉक्टर्स को डॉक्टर्स बनाऊँगा. डॉक्टर्स को डॉक्टर बनाना बहुत बड़ी बात होती है, क्योंकि जनरली बैचलर ऑफ मेडिसिन और बैचलर ऑफ सर्जरी की डिग्री ले लेना तो आसान है, लेकिन डॉक्टर होकर डॉक्टर बनना थोड़ा मुश्किल काम है. सो आई एम एसोसिएटेड विद गुरुकुल 24/7, one of the fastest growing teaching platforms in India. So I pass on my mic to ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhinav, and we give you a warm welcome. And Mary has flown in all the way from France. Je t'aime vous. Those are the only lines I know.
Bonsoir à tout le monde. I am happy to be here. You have the very good example of French education in front of you, because in French we are very bad for language. So I learned many years English, and I am very bad. I am not proud of my English. So you have the example. So I was a teacher during 12 years in Africa. But during this year, I have no tablet, no iPhone, no internet, nothing. So I am very happy, because since a long time. So after I developed a school for handicapped children, mentally disabled, you understand? And now I am a directrice in France of a house like Orfolina. So the education, it's the principal problem. Yes, I am very, the big education, not only in school, but I must give education of the all children in my house.
Thank you, Marie. Good afternoon, I am Lakshya Chabaria. I am director of SR Capital Group of Schools and president of Affordable Private School Association. I will tell my story that forming an association comes with a pain. एक दर्द से शुरुआत है जो एजुकेशन के अंदर प्रॉब्लम है समस्याएं हैं उसको एडवोकेसी के थ्रू हम लेके जाएं आगे इसको ठीक कैसे कर सकते हैं एंड टुडे दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम मैंने रियलाइज़ किया कि हमें सिस्टम को ठीक करने की बजाय पहले अपने आप को ठीक करना ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है अपने आप से कनेक्ट होना ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है सोल कनेक्शन हु यू आर और वट आर यू द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ जब तक आप इस क्वेश्चन का जवाब नहीं ढूंढोगे अपने आप से आप एजुकेशन में काम नहीं कर सकते और चेंज नहीं ला सकते तो महात्मा गांधी भी ने भी बोला है बी द चेंज यू वांट टू सी इन द वर्ल्ड तो पहले कोशिश मेरी ये थी कि ब्रिंग द चेंज इन माई सेल्फ देन उसके बाद काम करें और बहुत अच्छा काम चल रहा है टेक्नोलॉजी को हम किस तरह से एजुकेशन में अपनी पैडागॉजी में ला सकते हैं टुडे इज़ द टॉपिक एंड आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू से वी आर यूजिंग गूगल असिस्टेंट एंड मैनी टेक्नोलॉजी जो हमारी टीचर्स थी बहुत सारी ऐसी थी जिन्होंने कभी लैपटॉप यूज़ नहीं किया था दे आर यूजिंग गूगल असिस्टेंट इवन हिंदी टाइपिंग शी इज़ हेयर दिस इज़ बीना सिंह क्वेश्चन पेपर भी उनको टाइप करना बड़ा मुश्किल होता था हिंदी का तो वो गूगल असिस्टेंट यूज करके आज हिंदी के पेपर टाइप कर रही हैं बिग बिग क्लैप फॉर हर एंड आई पास ऑन माइक टू मिस्टर अशोक पांडे
थैंक यू लक्ष्य जी आप ही की तरह अगर सबका लक्ष्य हो तो कितना अच्छा होता तो मैं अशोक पांडे आई एम हेडिंग स्कूल्स हियर मैं डायरेक्टर है मेरी उपाधि लेकिन मैं बड़ा खुश हूँ कि ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ने मुझे सीनियर डायरेक्टर आज बना दिया इसी शाम तो मैं आपकी उम्मीदों पे खरा उतरूँ
थैंक यू मिस्टर पांडे आई एम शालिनी जायसवाल एंड आई एम डायरेक्टर एकेडमिक्स एंड टीचर ट्रेनिंग विद मेपल बेयर चेन ऑफ प्री स्कूल्स So we are present over 22 countries and in India we have around quite a few branches but mainly dealing with pre-primary and elementary education.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Suresh. I'm a teacher. I'm a teacher. I headed a few schools abroad. I worked in England for 8-9 years and few other countries and I headed few schools in India and now I'm a trainer. I won't say consultant. I'm a teacher trainer and I'm helping people to, you know, enhance their skills. I won't say I train. Everybody has skills. You have to enhance it. So I'm doing it.
मैं वीरेंद्र कुमार हरित पिछले 43 साल से योग सिखा रहा हूँ मेरी उम्र 67 साल है जैसे अभी कहा स्वामी जी ने प्रभु ने खुश मैं खुश हूँ मेरी कोई तमन्ना नहीं है सब इच्छाएं पूरी हैं मेरी कहाँ गए वो स्वामी जी
He is coming.
मेरी सारी इच्छाएं पूरी हैं कोई तमन्ना नहीं आई एम हैप्पी और मैं योग कहाँ सिखाता हूँ पहले अफ्रीका में था उसके बाद यूरोप आया पिछले 22 साल से मैं यूरोप में हूँ और मेरे 5 योगा सेंटर हैं योग मनोविज्ञान है योग आसन नहीं है योग मनोविज्ञान है श्रीमद् भगवद गीता मनोविज्ञान है A to Z योग होलिस्टिक है लेकिन लोग योग को नहीं जानते आसन कर लिया योग सीख लिया 2-4 प्राणायाम कर लिए ये योग नहीं है योग है यम नियम प्रत्याहार सारी साइकोलॉजिकल की जो एक्सरसाइज वो सब प्रत्याहार में है, उपनिषदों से निकली हुई है। और योग को तो अपने जीवन में अपनाना चाहिए। और आज की तारीख में जो योग है वो योग नहीं है, वो भोग है। योगी तो क्रोधी नहीं होता। क्यों लोग क्रोधी हैं? योग करते हैं, योग करवाते हैं और वो योग क्रोधी हैं, तो वो योग नहीं है, वो मेरे हिसाब से भोग है।
Hi, good afternoon all. At the onset, I really appreciate the organizer because this mixed bag is really interesting, right? Because we have almost everyone from industry, from school, teacher, and interestingly from the yoga side also. My name is Kumar. I represent a company called Upgrad. Upgrad is basically into executive program, that too which is confined with the AI, ML, artificial intelligence and machine learning. So what we do that for anyone who is already working with a corporate or maybe institution, right? If they want to reskill their career or reskilling, right? Especially in terms of having knowledge about new age programs that too confined with the machine learning, artificial intelligence. This is what we do. Now, recently we are going to enhance our portfolio and getting alliance with different universities and in the same path with the schools also, considering that it's something which is need of our. We are sitting tomorrow discussing the topic, right? And I'm sure the relevance of technology, innovation to attend the global standard is something which is very important and crucial, especially from the school. Subsequently, definitely, during the discussion, I'll put across the points. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody. And I just got a message from the organizer. We have only 25 minutes. So I request everybody will try and shorten it up. Because let's not forget what is the crux of the issue. We are still teaching in the, you know, the classrooms are still 19th century, the teachers are still 20th century, and the kids are 21st century. And whether we want to admit it or not in a conference, but yes, we are still teaching in a very traditional method to the children who are technologically very, very advanced. So Dr. Abhinav, you're a young soul. How do you think, I'm going to ask you a very, very specific question because we have to ask everybody, what do you think, why have we not been able to integrate technology properly in the classroom in an Indian school?
बहुत बेहतरीन सवाल पूछा है मैम ने, और एक लाइन का आंसर है, एक वर्ड का आंसर है, दैट इज गाइडेंस। बच्चों के हाथ में फोन दे दिया गया है और सबसे ज्यादा उस पर जो आप मोस्ट सर्च साइट्स आप देखेंगे तो वो इंस्टाग्राम, ट्विटर या फेसबुक होती है। ईस्ट एंजलिया यूनिवर्सिटी है नॉर्विक में, मैं कॉन्फ्रेंस के लिए वहां था, इवन डेनी पेट्रोगस्ट मेडिकल स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी यूक्रेन में भी, वहां पर आप 11वीं क्लास के बच्चे के कोर्स सिलेबस में मेडिकल में एक वर्ड आता है एथेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस, जिसको अगर आप लोग जानते हो तो आगे चल के वो बाईपास ग्राफ्टिंग में बहुत बड़ा रोल प्ले करती है। अगर किसी को एथेरियोस्क्लेरोसिस हो जाए तो उसको बाईपास ग्राफ्टिंग करवाई जाती है। ईस्ट एंजलिया स्टेट मेडिकल यूनिवर्सिटी में लंदन का जो सबसे बड़ा सर्जन अगर लंदन में कहीं पर सर्जरी कर रहा है तो वाया वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग क्लास 11th के बच्चे को भी दिखाया जाता है। ये हम अपने स्कूल्स में लाने की कोशिश नहीं कर पा रहे। मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि अगर इस तरीके के इनोवेशन समिट्स पे, अगर इतने सारे इंटेलेक्चुअल्स के बीच में बैठकर इस तरीके के नॉलेज पे अगर काम किया जाए, हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कर भी रही है इस पे, तो मेरे को लगता है कि बहुत ज्यादा चेंजेस आ सकते हैं।
थैंक यू अभिनव। What is very important is I want everybody should take a takeaway from here कि हम कैसे टेक्नोलॉजी इंट्रोड्यूस करें क्लासरूम में। सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम यू मारिया, हाउ इज इट इन फ्रांस, आर द स्कूल्स अलाउइंग चिल्ड्रन टू कैरी स्मार्टफोन्स इन द क्लासरूम एंड हाउ डू दे वर्क ऑन इट?
सो द गवर्नमेंट सिंस 2 years the children, the students can come in the school with a smartphone. But of course, they have in the pocket. But if the teacher see a smartphone, she will take it, and the parents, yes. But about the sixth class, now the school give a tablet to learn because there are many books in the
bag, and so the government give a tablet to learn. Yes. And of course, at home, it's like in India, it's like everywhere. The tablet, the smartphone, all children since 12 years old have a tablet. And how is because the tablet, books, and always in the tablet, Facebook.
My question to you, you're a very young, handsome man starting a school. Oh, I love it. He just said that children are going continuously on Facebook, on Twitter, Instagram. How many of us are on Facebook? Please raise your hands quickly. Yes. Instagram, Twitter, all of us are. How do we tell a child, I want to ask you, because you are young, I'm sure you're on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Instagram is more with you or this thing. How do you tell a child? I mean, because Facebook today is not something to be shy of, it's a business tool. People are using to branding themselves, marketing themselves, and I think it's perfectly, so how do you educate a child that these are not tools which the child should be using in the classroom?
Yeah, actually this answer was given by Mr. Prabhu, because students are not aware who they are not connected with themselves, they are not aware about their passion. If they know what is their passion, what they want to become in their life, what things drives them the most, then their focus will be towards that goal. They will never be distracted. They use each and every tool like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to support their goal, to support their passion. That's what I want to say, that students must be aware of their possibilities and work on them. Thank you.
Thank you. I just want Ashok sir, he's an old friend of mine and a great learned man, and I have a very interesting question for you, sir. I feel that children today, or we all today, are on social media or virtual reality or technology in the classroom because we are very lonely. We have forgotten what relationships are. The parents are busy, so the children are going into these kind of things. We recently had that blue whale thing which was going around. So sir, what is your opinion that how can technology, because it is important in the classroom, how do you think we can make it where we are able to understand and gel it with innovative methodology?
Thank you, Shalini ji. Aapne friendly sawal pucha hai, and I'm very happy about it. I have got just 4 minutes to my quota, and I'll try and rush through this answer. You see, Swamiji asked a question, what is the purpose of education? And if time was allowed, all 100 people sitting here would have given 100 answers to that. Now, if purpose of education is so wide, so deep, and so broadened, I can assure you, with due respect to young friends like Dr. Tripathi, technology cannot answer that. And technology no way can serve those 100 purposes of education. So this, number one, I come from here. Number two, in 1965, the then President of America, John F. Kennedy, in one of the commencement lectures in a university, he asked three questions. That, can we provide education to all of our children in America? Number two, can we provide quality education to all our children in America? And question number three, are we capable of preparing all our children for the future of America? These are the three questions he asked in 1965. 2019 draft education policy of India is also asking the same three questions today. Same three questions. The crux of the policy for school education is every child is to be enrolled, every child is to be given quality education, and third is, for this uncertain world today and even more uncertain world tomorrow, is our child ready for that or not? And therefore, we will try and search out the answer in the classroom. So the classrooms are diverse, the challenges of the classrooms are very varied, and what do we want? We want that every child's learning outcome must improve, and every child must have the joy and fruits of learning. And every child should be ready to negotiate the vagaries of life.
and every child should productively, efficiently contribute to the society. Now, if this is the purpose, I think technology has to support us to improve the learning outcomes, to make learning joyful, to answer the differentiations in the classroom, to help us predict what is the problem of the child, and also tell us what are the correct remedies for that problem, and how we can assess in such a way that every child feels that he or she has been assessed very fairly. If these answers can be provided by technology, and we can very clearly define that this is the purpose of technology, and here is my technological solution, I think teachers will be in a position to use it, and children will benefit from it. That's my very, very considered opinion. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Shalini, you are the same name.
Yeah. So
I recently saw there's a young mother who came home, and she had a little toddler. This question is to you. And so she was feeding the little one who was crying, throwing tantrums, and was refusing to eat. So what the mother did, she had a sort of a Velcro coin. She put her, I found it very amazing and hilarious. She stuck her phone on her forehead, right? And she put on the cartoons, and the child was just looking there, and she fed him within 10 minutes. So the challenges we are facing when the children come to the big school, as we call it, is they are already addicted to smartphones. Mm-hmm. And we are trying to ward them away from those behaviors. So how do you handle it in your school chain? What is your input on this?
Yeah, as you rightly said, children are, they are exposed to technology before they come to school as toddlers, and mothers find it very easy to distract the child. But what we believe in is that if you provide something interactive, if you provide something meaningful for the child, which is engaging and interesting, the child will not look at technology. The child mostly looks at an interaction, that interpersonal touch, and the interaction between the teacher and the child, the kind of materials you provide the child to kind of help learning in a preschool environment, and then moving on to elementary, what kind of learning you have, it's very important. Technology at a younger age is not, we believe, is not needed, especially in a preschool. It's more of the personal connect with the teacher, the interpersonal relationship, which builds a foundation for social emotional relationships. As we said, children now would, if you have a group of friends, you will see them talking on WhatsApp rather than actually interacting with each other. This is the reason is because they haven't been, the ability to build relationship or talk, face to face is missing. That's what the school should provide. As children grow, technology should be used as tools for learning. As Mr. Pandey said, you should be using it when there is a need to achieve a specific learning outcome. It should be intentional. It is not that I have a smart board, I show them a video, I'm using technology, but it should be intentional to achieve a specific learning outcome. Where teachers should be very careful in choosing what kind of technology, what am I using as a resource, and what age group am I addressing? And is that resource able to address the learning outcome, what I started with, to achieve or support my learning? So it should always be used as a support. It's not the end, but sometimes used as a means to reach an outcome. It should also encourage children to be able to reflect, question, create or enhance relationships. So there should be, it should not be a passive use of technology. It should lead to discussions, interactive use of technology amongst children, or discussions, where children are talking to each other. They're learning new things, doing research. As they grow, they should know how to use technology in a proper way, in a meaningful way, in a positive way, because that's very important. We can't avoid technology. As children grow, they should be adept at using technology and should not have a phobia for it, because when they grow, they would be facing it. But at the same time, we should not use it, it's not that the teacher is replaceable. She is there, the materials, the touch, feel, all those things are an integral part of the classroom.
Right, thank you so much. My question to you, Suresh, is, like she said, we should not expose them, but we cannot avoid it. If you notice around here where we are sitting, we are all surrounded by artificial intelligence. My phone is telling me how many steps I have walked. The children are aware, the teacher is not aware. That's the funniest. When I was taking a session with a class of grade 7 and I asked them, do you know what is artificial intelligence? And really, this was fifth, sorry, and a grade 5 kid was very much aware. They have come up with a lot of innovations. Like I have seen kids of grade 5, where will the lightning strike? Be able to predict that. They are much advanced. I think technology is extremely important, but we are not able to introduce it in the classroom because we ourselves don't know. So that is what a challenge is. We are not able to see, we are very happy when we see the report cards and one click and I get to know this child, what he got in grade 1, but I'm not able to use it in the classroom. So I would like you to tell me how we can integrate.
With what I have seen in last 3 years since I've shifted here, people go to Finland. I've seen it has become a business of sending principal to Finland, and then now yesterday I saw to Italy, to France, to Germany. For what? And when it comes to technology, as Shalini said, you're totally confused. I know somebody told me the other day, the past is teaching your future. I got annoyed being a teacher, you know, somebody tells me that I'm the past. Then I realized, you know, somewhere mujhe laga, shayad usne sach hi bola hai. Kyun? Being a teacher, always we have, you know, a kind of criticism which we tell our owners, inhone mere upar paise invest nahi kiye hain, training nahi dete hain, continuous training nahi dete hain. But all of us, we carry smartphones, right? As Shalini said, a grade 5 child knows. Sabke paas phone hai. The only thing is, we never try to use it properly. And recently, I won't name the school, I was giving training in one of the schools and English teacher padha rahi thi and smart board band ho gaya. You know, what is the immediate reaction of the teacher? Sir ko bula ke leke ho. And what is the reaction of the student? They started laughing. So somewhere I feel the transfusion of technology into teaching, theek tarah se nahi hua hai. You know, the core of any school are teachers. Hum kitne bhi conferences mein baat kar le, kuch bhi kar le, unless you train them, it is not going to help. You know, people talk about Finland. If you have seen in Finland, or I worked in England, I think teachers are given more importance. Teachers are being trained because they are core of any school. But hamare desh ka ye hal hai, I'm not talking about metros, baaki small cities, teacher do clerical job, you know, unko time hi nahi milta, report books itne likhte hain. So where you will learn about technology, where you are going to empower with your kids who are in the classroom, you know. So that part we have to work it on. And I, jaise subah chief guest saab ne bola tha, it's very easy to speak, lekin kitne jane jaate hain. I'm a consultant, maine yahan dekha hai, aajkal ki kai log industries se aake teacher training dete hain. But how many of you are ready to go and teach in one of the villages in Pune about 21st century skills? Koi nahi jayega. So it will take another 30 years to infuse technology into schooling, and I don't know how successful it will be.
No, I don't think so. It will take 30 years. We are almost there, and we are pretty good. So in my school, I used to have an innovation period where children could stay back after school.
Nothing but gentle.
Yeah. And even I've been teaching in the Anganwadis now, which are like at the root and the tribal schools. And I tell you, the teachers are very advanced. So we have the enthusiasm. So sir, my next question is to you. Main yoga ka hi puchungi aapse, because main yoga bahut karti hu and main bahut manti hu. Aur mujhe jo ek bahut sad cheez lagta hai, ki Indian schools mein yoga ek period hota hai. Indian schools mein yoga is more practiced in America, jabki hamara origin hai. Or maine jab, I think our day should begin with yoga, with alom bilom and kapal bharti. 5 minutes lagta hai. How can we change the way school owners and school everybody thinks? Ki this is not a period. This is nothing to be. This is life. This is breathing.
Yoga is life. Yeah. Yoga jo hai jivan hai. Aur jo aaj school mein yoga jo karaya jata hai, wo gymnastic hai. सर्कस है आप क्या बात कर रहे हैं वो योग नहीं है आप उसको मैं क्या बताऊं, मैं हर साल देखता हूं, आजकल तो कंपटीशन हो गया है और ये योग कंपटीशन में चला जाएगा एक दिन। वो जो हमारा जो मानसिक योग है, जो हमारा वेदों में उपनिषद में लिखा हुआ है, वो कहाँ है? वो जो श्रीमद् भगवत गीता भगवान कृष्ण ने अर्जुन को बताया योग, वो योग कहाँ है? मैं उस योग की बात कर रहा हूँ, मैं जिम्नास्टिक की बात नहीं कर रहा, मैं सर्कस की बात नहीं कर रहा, ये तो सर्कस है। आप जो योग करते हैं अनुलोम, ये कोई प्राणायाम नहीं है, है प्राणायाम, प्राणा का मतलब कंट्रोल, यम प्राणायाम का मतलब है लाइफ, यम का मतलब है कंट्रोल, वो कंट्रोल तो है ही नहीं, तो आप कहां से अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम कर रहे हो? अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम तो कंट्रोल से किया जाता है, है उसकी टेक्निक्स है, ऐसे नहीं है कि वो है। आप एकदम अगर आप अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम कर रहे हो तो आपके अंदर क्रोध क्यों आता है? आपके अंदर क्रोध नहीं आना चाहिए। और अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम तो एक ऐसा प्राणायाम है कि अगर उसको एक महीने तक आदमी नित्य करे 10 मिनट्स, उसकी कंसंट्रेशन डेवलप हो जाएगी, उसका माइंड कंट्रोल हो जाएगा। माइंड कंट्रोल नहीं है, अनुलोम विलोम प्राणायाम करते हैं तो वो उसको, तो जो स्कूल में जो योग कराया जाता है उसके लिए तो वो जिम्नास्टिक है, वो सर्कस है, वो सर्कस कर रहे हैं, है? उसको तो कुछ भी कह दो, एक्स वाई जेड।
थैंक यू सर। सर कोशिश तो करेंगे हम, बिकॉज मेरे ख्याल से जो सांस है उसकी वैल्यू जब आप बिल्कुल उस यू नो व्हेन यू आर लाइंग इन एन आईसीयू लाइक आई वाज, उस दिन मुझे समझ आई कि जिसको ब्रीदिंग को हम बहुत लाइटली लेते हैं, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड आई रिस्पेक्ट।
बिकॉज जीवन क्या है, जीवन क्या है, आप सब लोग बैठे, जीवन क्या है? सांस है,
सांस।
अगर सांस के ऊपर आपने ध्यान नहीं किया, सांस के ऊपर आपने कंट्रोल नहीं किया, आपका जीवन बेकार है।
दैट्स अ फैक्ट। थैंक यू सो मच। सो वी विल मूव ऑन। या थैंक यू मिस्टर कुमार गौरव, आर यू फ्रॉम द बॉलीवुड? एक गाना मेरा फेवरेट था उस टाइम का। अच्छा, ओके। सो मिस्टर गौरव, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट जो फ्यूचर स्कूल्स हैं, राइट? इट्स ऑल अबाउट आइदर कोलैबोरेटिव लर्निंग और इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड लर्निंग, एंड दैट्स व्हाई दे आर सेइंग कि टेक्नोलॉजी का इतना इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल होएगा, बिकॉज बच्चे आजकल सेल्फ लर्न कर लेते हैं। जैसे क्लास में टीचर ने कुछ चैप्टर दिया, वो फ्लिप्ड लर्निंग और ये सब है, द चिल्ड्रन नो मच मोर। वो कहते हैं मैम बोर मत करो, आप कुछ और पढ़ाओ, ये तो हम भी कर लेंगे। सो हाउ डू यू थिंक दैट, वॉट इज द फ्यूचर, हाउ, वॉट शुड बी फ्यूचर स्कूल्स लुक लाइक इन इंडिया? आई मीन वी हैव टू चेंज, राइट?
So, allow me, you know, I'm taking 3 points from the last 4 panelists, right? What we are trying to address, number one, that the presentability of technology, at least everyone, all of us admit technology is important, right? Yes, we all agree. But the problem possibly is content of technology, right? Because what we are worried about, that now suppose if I'm giving a mobile to my kid, right, what is the content that he's looking at? That's a kind of a problem. That's the number one. Number two, are, you know, the teachers, right, do they have adequate competency about technology? Possibly no. It'll take time. That's the second crux, which, you know, most of the panelists have discussed. Point number three, which is a direct question to me, that what would be the future in terms of, you know, introducing technology and all. I tell you one thing, the answer of your question were the first 2 points, which was already discussed. It's just articulation, right, which I'll try to put it across. Trust me, technology serve a larger issue. What is that I tell you? Now, suppose this room is a full of 100 teachers learned, right? Now, is this really sufficient kind of what is required in India? No. Let's use technology to distribute that thing, to escalate or empower that thing. That's the number one. And the same thing possibly will happen in future also, right? So if I talk about a future, it means, of course, we everyone need to use technology, considering that we know technology well. And then only we can impart that this is how, you know, we should intervene with technology and, you know, use technology. So that's a point number one. Point number two would be that it's a part of a bit of a funny thing, because what Shalini was referring to, I have a kid of 3 years, right? And every time when he go to, you know, have his food, the very first thing what he asked to his mom, give me mobile. Once I asked that, why? You're going to have your food. He said, no, I'm going to have my food. That's why I'm asking mobile. So this is how, right? So definitely, what she rightly pointed out, that maybe in earlier stage, this is not required. Here, the intervention of a parent is something which is very crucial and important. There is no role of a teacher at this point in time. This is a parent, basically, right? What material we are giving to those teacher, it's a problem of a teacher, a problem of a parent, not a teacher. So yes, in early age, we all are culprit, right? As long as we admit that, yes, you know, we don't know that, you know, how to deal with this problem. I wish I could know this answer of this thing also, because I'm also facing this trouble. So just summing up, future definitely would be based on two things, that how good we, everyone as a teacher, know using of technology, number one. Number two, that we are not enough in terms of a number, so technology will definitely help us to escalate those things, you know, in terms of distribution and all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm a big follower of time. It's 1 minute, which I'll just like to wind up and thank everybody. What is very important is that we are not giving importance in schools to cyberbullying, cyber ethics. We are not talking about it. It's spoken about as if ki koi extra, koi Mars se koi aake sikhayega, which should be ingrained in a professional development program. And you, if you tell a child that you don't take a phone, then he will take it. I can tell you that in written. So we used to have 2 days in a week where I used to tell kids, I was a school head, I used to tell them, no, you can get your phones. And teachers ladte the mujhse, ki nahi, aap galat kar rahe, main kahi kuch nahi hoega. Because what I wanted to teach was not about, wo to wo galat sahi, to hum sabne bhi bahut kuch kara hai apni life mein. What I wanted to teach them is very important value. I trust you. I know you will not do anything wrong. Wo technology se nahi sikha sakte. I wanted to teach them that I have confidence in you. Ki aap agar kuch, agar usne WhatsApp mein apni girlfriend ki photo bhi khich li, hum sabne kara hai. We have to teach the kids actually what is good, what is right. How many of you play Candy Crush? I'm addicted. Honestly, I get up in the morning and main Candy Crush wo life mangte rehte hain logo se. It's nothing wrong. And the best part is, I would like to thank each one of you. The technology person is sleeping. So he's in deep sleep, because this is what a disengaged classroom is, jahan technology ke bekair hum padha rahe hain. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much. Please visit it for a minute. We want to
thank Dr. Shashi also for organizing this, and we really enjoyed. And thank you, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, respected members. Just wait for a minute. Now I would like to call on behalf of EDUTalk and School Innovation Summit on the stage, Mr. C.B. Mishra ji. Please come and facilitate our panelist. Mr. Kumar Gaurav, please give him a big round of applause. Just then. Cameraman, please click a pic. Congratulations, sir. तालियां बजती रहें तो अच्छा लगेगा. हार्ट, अभी हमने सुना था, ब्लड सर्कुलेशन इंक्रीज होता है, हार्ट प्रॉब्लम्स खत्म होती हैं. सो नेक्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू कॉल मिस शालिनी नामब्यार. थैंक यू मैम, इट वॉज सच अ वंडरफुल सेशन. Miss Mary Pascal, Miss Mary Pascal Harit. Please. Yogi Virendra Harit. Yogi ji, Yogi sir, please. Next, Mr. Anirudh Gupta ji, nahi hai. Okay. Next, Mr. Ashok Pandey ji. It's a pleasure for everything, sir. Mr. Lakshya Chabaria. Miss Shalini Jaiswal. Miss Shalini Jaiswal. Please taliyan bajana nahi chhodiyega. We would like to listen your claps. Mr. S. Suresh Kumar. Abhinav. Okay, Mr. Abhinav Tripathi ji, please. I'm really sorry. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.